This is TreppWire Week in Review for week ending September 17th. I'm Martha Kota with Trepp, a data modeling and analytics firm for the CMBX commercial real estate and CLO markets. I'm with Manus Clancy, Senior Managing Director, and Joe McBride, Head of CRE Finance this week.
Wait. How are we just going to go right into this like this? We have to acknowledge something here. Some of our listeners may know this, but just in case you don't, this is the 100th episode of the TreppWire podcast. Can you believe this, Manus?
Well, as I was thinking about it before we got started, I was thinking to myself, this is like Martha stock. You know, this is like a big, meaningful threshold for us, you know, a big number. We have a couple of special treats down below. So not only will Joe and I and Martha be cavorting today, we also have some special guests at the end of the podcast that you'll have to stick around and listen for. But yeah, Martha stock with a cast of thousands.
Well, you know, we need to thank our listeners. There's a lot of competition out there for podcasts. And because of you, our humble pod is in the top percentile of podcasts.
Yeah. The funny thing about podcast distributions is that if you looked at, you know, we're in the top single digit percents of podcasts, which is amazing, but we're still about 3.975 million listens below Joe Rogan. So the difference between the 1% and the top and the 0.1% is a big difference. But Manus hates when we talk about this stuff because he hates to talk highly of himself or any of us at all. But the whole point of this is not to talk highly of ourselves. It's actually to talk highly of our listeners who have been just great this entire time. I mean, we get messages on LinkedIn, we get Twitter, anonymous people on Twitter, non-anonymous people on Twitter. You know, I just played golf this morning with a real estate pro who we kind of met through the podcast. So, you know, there's so many examples of this, and the fact that people keep listening and keep giving us great information from their areas of the market is just humbling in a lot of ways. So I can't believe it's been 100 episodes. I remember looking at you three folks when we first started this. I was in a different place, living situation. I had one fewer children. So
child?
A lot one of fewer child's child. Children, like fewer one child. Less child. No, it's fewer.
No, fewer. It's a countable
one
thing.
Fewer children. Yeah. I don't know how you say that, but we've had a lot of grammar child. Lessons on this 100 episodes as well. So, you know, it's kind of like every week we do a podcast and time just goes by, but the TreppWire podcast keeps on humming. And so do you guys listening.
Well, I would say a couple of things. First of all, I was a skeptic of the whole thing to begin with. And I'm so grateful that Martha and others talked me into doing this because it has been a blast. And the people we've met along the way have just been wonderful. I'm really grateful that what we do and the engagement that we get is not social media-esque or Twitter-esque, right? You know, I wasn't on Twitter for very long and I haven't been a real social media presence at any point in my life. But the few times that I've seen it, it just seems to go dark so quickly. The negative thoughts and the vitriol. And I was afraid that, you know, maybe if we went down this path, it just wouldn't be rewarding. And what I found is that every comment we get is really thoughtful, even for people that disagree with a point of view that we made or some of the data we've looked at. It's on such a high level. It's just so professional and well thought out and defensible that it's really restorative to know that there's people out there that want to have an adult conversation, you know, and I think that that's been the best part of it. Other things that I just want to call out, you know, we've had some fundraisers here for the Barstool Fund. People were very generous about that, making donations to help the restaurants and the nail salons and the dry cleaners along the way. We've had people come on as guests. We've had people share their research with us. So really, they've expressed condolences or congratulations for big family events for us. All of those things, we are just so lucky to have you as an audience. And I can't really underscore that enough.
You say adult conversations, Manus. I think we're about 50-50 on the adult conversations, at least on this podcast.
Ish.
Well, for just one moment, I've given us way too much credit than we deserve. So you're absolutely right on that matter.
Some of the stats that we've tracked in the last 100 episodes have taken us on a wild ride. COVID case count, travel numbers, unemployment, occupancies, and loan delinquencies have gone from some crazy peaks at their worst to what we're now calling the new normal. So we're going to take a few minutes and take a look back at some of those numbers.
Yeah. So